I have seen.
Doing today's main stories now, a Logan dad has ignored claims to break down a door and drag his wife to safety from their burning home. A powerful inquiry will be launched into shady operators in the southeast tow truck industry. Australia's finished ninth in the Eurovision Song Contest after a streaker draped in an Aussie flag gatecrashed the stage. And while many Queensland mums have been spoiled, others started their Mother's Day raising money for breast cancer research. Checking fuel costs, the RACQ recommends only topping up the fuel tank as prices are still falling. Tonight in 7 News Flashback, when our wallets, purses and pockets change forever. On this day in 1984, the first $1 coin was introduced. Sounds straightforward, but not in Queensland. Our government called for the coins to be boycotted, our young reports.
From now on, the old $1 note will be replaced by a new $1 coin. It's been designed after talking to a vast number of people so that it will be convenient to carry and won't become worn and soiled.
$1 notes have been in circulation since 1966. The Treasurer Paul Keating wanted to get rid of them.
The reason for change is because the notes wear out. And the last 4 or 5 months, I think, where these go on for 40 years.
The Royal Australian Mint churned them out, ready for changeover there.
The first time you get one, take a good look at it. It has a distinct yellow gold appearance with the image of Her Majesty the Queen on one side and 5 kangaroos on the other.
The first of the $1 coins hit the streets early this morning and at the same time collected state government criticism. Queensland's Consumer Affairs Minister, Vince Lester, talked of a boycott.
In fact, they will be in the public. In fact, if you've got them in the third pocket of your wallet, you'll have to do a little hole in the pocket of your trousers.
Just hope the girl doesn't wear it off a bit
of
they want
them
in their purses, you know.
The girl didn't wear off, and our pockets survived.
When you think of it, it was only a matter of time before they did bring in a coin to replace the dollar note, because in the 18 years since these notes were taken out of circulation and replaced by these, the value of our money, of course, has eroded considerably. Back in 1966, if you had one of these, you had a reasonable wage. Very few people would like to live on the equivalents today.
Since production began, 924 million $1 coins have gone into circulation. They've always been popular with collectors, but the buying power of a dollar has steadily fallen.
I like the fun thing. You know, in a way, this new $1 coin is a bit of a social comment in itself. That's the same size as the 10 cent coin, which is the same as the old shilling. And I can remember when you used to be able to buy a beer from a shilling. Not as tall as you don't have a shilling. Then again, there ain't too much change these days. From a dollar. I just wonder how long it's going to last.